started with a yogurt that I found in my refrigerator that was 6 months past date. It was the only yogurt I had at the time, and I wanted to make a smoothie.
That smoothie motivated Scott Nash to make some changes. Instead of throwing food out.
And there's a bunch of pepperonis in here. They expire November 12th last year.
Nash makes dinner with expired foods he has in the kitchen. In this case, pizza.
Perfectly good. Mmm. Okay, yummy.
Nash is the founder and owner of Mom's Organic Market. He hates wasting food, and to prove it can be safe, he and his family ate expired foods for an entire year. He documented it in his blog.
I'm proof that for years I've been eating way past expired food. Heavy cream, milk, meat, eggs.
We have this milk, which is April 30th, that we just started using a couple days ago. It has turned.
Yes.
So this one we're not going to use.
All of these products have dates and different advisories on them. Sell by, freeze by, use by, best by, and they all mean different things.
Usually they are there to prove quality and created by the manufacturer. It's not a safety date. The Food and Drug Administration says Americans are throwing out the equivalent of $165 billion in food each year, a lot of it by consumers because of misunderstandings of what food product dating means.
I feel like we could reduce so much waste if we just had smart food dating systems.
The food industry agrees and is working on a voluntary, simplified labeling system. David Fikes is with the Food Marketing Institute. He says FMI is working with the Grocery Manufacturers Association to cut down on consumer confusion by using just two labels. One is best if used by.
If you want the best bang for your buck, if you want the highest quality for the money you've spent on this food, you will consume this food by that particular date. It's best by that date.
The other is used by.
There are those products that suffer from a material degradation to the point that you really need to use it by that particular date. There may be a substantial loss, not only in the quality and taste, but also in the potential safety of the product.
There is no federal law mandating expiration dates on food, with the exception of baby formula. Some states require it for meat and milk to avoid wasting food. The Nashes also cook meats in bulk before they go bad.
If left unattended, they are going to expire, and that would be wasteful. So even though we're only going to eat a little bit of chicken that night, he'll cook it all on the grill.
That way the food is stable and can be eaten over several days. While it's going to take people a while to change their habits about consuming food according to these dates, Nash offers this.
Trust your eyes and your nose, then that's probably the best test of all.
Lisa Robinson, WBAL-TV 11 News.